To create a Garry's Mod map, you first have to go into Steam, right-click on Garry's Mod, click Properties, go to Local Files, click Browse Local Files, go into Bin, scroll down to hammer.exe, open it, go to File, and click New. Now we're going to want to create a hollow box. So that's going to be a small room, for our example map. Increase our grid size by clicking here. Go to Block Tool. This will basically just create a block. And scroll in, and create a block on this grid. This is the top one. This is the side. This is front. And this is the viewport. You can look around the viewport by clicking Z, and using WASD to look around. As you see, this is the preview of our block. If we click Enter, then it will show up. Next thing you're going to want to do is click up here, click on 3D text shaded texture polygons, so that this shows a texture. Click on over here. Click on Browse. Look for a no-draw texture. Just search no-draw here. Use this one. And click the Apply Texture button. Now switch to your selection tool by either clicking S, Shift+S, or just clicking here. Now you're going to want to make this taller. Do whatever you want. I like this. Make it any size you want. Click on Tools. Make hollow. To hollow it outwards, do minus 32. And now you can go inside. If you want to create a spawn point, click on the Entity tool, Shift+E, or click here. Make sure this is on info. Make sure this is info player start. Click here. And align it to the grid. You can make the grid smaller if you wish to make it in the center of the room. Now, to apply textures to the walls and the floor and roof, click on this texture application tool, click on Browse, and look for a concrete floor texture. I like this one. Just double click on it, then right click on the floor to apply it. To create a wall texture, you can just go into Browse, search Wall, and choose whatever one you want. I like this one. Apply it to all the faces by pressing Z and then right clicking on each wall. Now you can look for a roof texture. Just search roof. Double click here. Right click on the roof. If you think the scale is wrong with it, then you can turn it up by just clicking here and turning up the texture scale on X and Y. Next, you're going to want to go into the Entity tool and create a light. Change this to light. Place it roughly in the center of the room. Now you can just go into the top and drag it to the center of the room. Use the side views to align it to the middle of the room. And you can increase in sprite and you can double click on it. Click on the 200. The last one is brightness. So you can turn it up to about 400. Apply. And quit out of this. Now, if you want to play your map in Gmod, click on File. Run Map. Now, make the name of your map whatever you want. For example, map. save. This is the first thing you'll see whenever you press run map. Basically, BSP is what makes the brushes, for example, these walls, and it also makes the entities. Viz calculates what is visible, and Rad calculates lighting. I want these all in normal, and we can click OK. This will compile the game and open it. For bigger maps, this will take a long time.